In this video, I share my struggles as a Christian leader and what I learned so far on my journey. Coming up. Hi, I'm Simon, and on this channel, I want to help you growing in your relationship with Jesus. First, two clarifications. I'll talk about situations that happened in my church. So if you think I talk about a situation where you are involved, then hit me up, because you can easily mistake me in this video. My motivation is not to slander against you. Just want to share what happened inside me in these situations and what I learned through them. Second, what leader am I? I'm the leader of our slides team and the co-leader of our youth group. Also, I'm one of the leaders of the general church tech. And in the last month, there are situations where I questioned if it really makes sense that I'm a leader in these areas. I am a guy who is always giving his best. My motivation, for example, is that our church service is as good as it gets. So a friend of mine and I are spending a lot of time optimizing little things that we reach that goal. And that's the reason why it hurts a lot when a colleague is screwing up. He forgot to unmute the preacher, so in the first 15 seconds, the people did not understand what the preacher was saying. And for me, that was a really difficult situation. I spent so much time on optimizing the little things, and he could not even manage to unmute the preacher so that the people will hear what he is saying. Also, we changed the slide with the announcement. We made a new design and a template for the people. But they didn't care about the new design. They just copied the announcements and pasted it in the template. After these two situations, but especially the first one, I spiraled really bad. I asked myself if it really makes sense what I'm doing. If it really makes sense that I'm optimizing the little things, that I'm leading in these areas, and the people are not following my example. The people are screwing up the basics, or the people didn't care what my friends and I made. On the way back home from the service where my colleague screwed up, I even started crying, because it didn't reach my desired level of quality. The following weeks I questioned if it really makes sense to be a leader, questioned my whole work. I thought you can only say to the people how they should do their job, but when they don't do that, you can't do anything about it. You can't kick them out like you would do in a normal job, especially not in a small church, because you don't have a lot of people to choose from. So what can you do instead as a leader? What does the Bible say about these difficult situations? What attributes should I have as a leader? But not so with you. Rather, let the greatest among you become as the youngest, the leader as one who serves. The greatest should be like the youngest, and the leader like the one who serves. So as a leader, you need to serve the people. And especially in our slides team, I didn't practice that. I looked for mistakes on their jobs and arranged the team, but I never served the people. But what does serving actually mean? Basically, you should also have a duty in your church where you serve, a duty that keeps you humbled. One teacher from a Bible school said, in the first year as an elder, his duty was to clean the church, and that kept him humbled. But for me, it means more investing into the people, serving them, asking how they are doing, asking if they have problems in their job, if everything is all right. And that way serving them. Not just managing them and making them aware of their mistakes, but also living in a close relationship to them. What can you do as a team member to help your leader and to serve effectively at your church? Obey your leaders and submit to them, for they are keeping watch over your souls, as those who will have to give account. Let them do this with joy and not with groaning, for that would be of no advantage to you. This verse is more referencing to the elders in church. But it also applies to every leader, that they should do their job with joy, not with groaning. How can you help achieving that goal? Simply follow your leader and ask them, either when you're unsure if your work is okay or when you're doing things different than usual. Then ask them and also not only talk with them about work, but also strengthen your relationship to your leader, like I wanna do. To summarize, I wanna serve by strengthening my relationship to the people, because the people matter and not the work. That way I can support them in their faith, and also support them in their work. You should also strengthen your relationship to your leader, and also ask them if you're doing something different than usual, or if you're not sure if your work is okay. Ask them and talk with them. That way, you and your leader can serve together God and building on His kingdom. Thank you.